In today's video, we're talking about how to start an LLC in Colorado. My name is Eric, and through this video, I'm going to guide you on three different possible ways that you can start up an LLC. You can do it through your state website, you can do it through online legal tools, and then you can also do it through an attorney. There's pros and cons whichever way you go, but if you do end up going through an attorney, I'm going to give you a tip on how you can possibly get a 15-minute consult for free so you don't have to start up the meter right away. But before we get into the different ways to start an LLC, there are a few things you should be aware of. So if you're not familiar with terms such as piercing the corporate veil, registered agents, or commingling funds, I'm going to be talking about all of those throughout this video, and they're very important to make sure that you have a legit LLC that is going to do what you need it to do for your business. So first, let's start off with the state website. Let's say you go to Google, you search LLC Colorado. The first listing here is file a form through Colorado Secretary of State. This is a great time to mention that any of the links or resources I'm mentioning in this video are in the description below, so you can click those links. Most of them are free. If any of them are an affiliate link, I will mark them as a paid link, but I appreciate you using my affiliate links as well because it helps support my channel on what I'm trying to do here on YouTube. So let's get back to the review. Now, I have looked at a lot of state websites, and I have to say that this is probably one of the more dated ones, but what you're going to do is click on this limited liability company right here to file a form. And I can tell you right off the bat, one of the things I don't love about this site is that this search right here is not directly tied to their database. So let's say I was to put in Broncos for the LLC name and you click next. Typically what you'd see is a warning message that would pop up to say that this is already taken. In this particular case, it lets you just kind of go right through. So it puts the onus on you to actually go back and go through their database to search to see if that's taken. 9 out of 10 state websites don't do that. It'll let you know right away that that's already taken. Now it's important because you have to have a unique name within your state. So I'm going to talk a little bit later as far as name searches and how you can do this in a little bit more effective way. So your eye may have noticed the fee of $50 up here. We'll talk about that real quick. That $50 fee, there is no way to get around that. If you're going through the state website, it's $50. If you're going through an online legal tool, it's $50. And if you go through an attorney, maybe they bake that into their fees, but at some point you're going to pay the state $50. And actually, as far as the state filing fees go, that is on the very low side. Some states such as Massachusetts can get up to over $400 for the filing fee. So I already mentioned I don't love the fact that it can just let me through with the name Broncos, which I'm sure is taken. But then the other thing I don't like either, once you get past your principal office address, is this section right here. The registered agent name and registered agent address of the entity's registered agent are, right? And this right here to me is an injustice to the people filling this out because it doesn't explain what a registered agent actually is and what they do for your business and how that pertains to having a proper LLC. So to explain a registered agent, I think what would be more helpful is to start first with what an LLC is and what it is not. And then we're going to talk about registered agents and piercing the corporate veil and why these terms are so important to you when you're setting up your LLC. So some people think that there's like a tax advantage for setting up an LLC. There is not. The reason you set up an LLC is simply to limit your liability. So what I want you to think about is your business and personal, right? And on the business side, you have assets, but on the personal side, you have assets as well. On the personal side, it may be things like your personal home, personal car, personal bank accounts. And what an LLC does is it draws a division between your business assets and your personal assets. So to like take a lot of the jargon out of it, that line in the middle, that division, that is creating protection for you for your personal assets. It's referred to as the corporate veil. But what happens is that attorney who is suing you is going to try and pierce the corporate veil. So that is them trying to find a crack in your LLC, see if it wasn't set up correctly, see if you may have issues. And if they can pierce the corporate veil, what happens is that protection is removed, and then they can come after not only your business assets, but your personal assets as well. Now, looking back on this page here, you can see that it talks about registered agents really fast, but it really doesn't get into what a registered agent is and what it does for your business. And that's really important now that you're familiar with the term piercing the corporate veil. So I'd like to take a moment and talk about registered agents in a little bit more detail. So this here is Inkfile. It's an online legal tool, so you can set up LLCs through it. But if you go down here, they have a list really quick of what a registered agent does. And it's official letters and correspondence from your Secretary of State, service of process notices. That's just a fancy way of saying if you get sued and you gotta show up to court. Official federal court or government correspondence information and notification. tax forms and requests for payment, and requests to complete permits and company filings or reports. So the registered agent is a third party from your business. It's a person who has their own address within the state of Colorado, but they're taking in important documents and then making sure that you're getting those documents, making sure that you're keeping up in your annual reports and filings, and basically making sure that you're compliant as an LLC. So where my issue with the state websites come in is they just tell you who is your registered agent. They don't explain what a registered agent is. And now you can see that the registered agent is pretty important. And if you just make it your cousin down the street because you're trying to save a few dollars, but they're not doing all these things, they're not doing it properly, they're creating a crack in your LLC, which is going to give the opportunity to pierce the corporate veil so that if you were sued, somebody could come after your business and personal assets at the same time. So it is not a shock that this state website is pretty rough, right? But this one is more rough than the average state website. And what I would recommend is to use a different tool, because you can pay the same amount of money, but you can get more information and better guidance by going through an online legal tool. So we take a look at Inkfile. You can see that they have joined over 500,000 businesses launched with Inkfile since 2004. One of the things I want to highlight here is that you can get started for as little as $0 plus your state fee. So I'm going to show you how that works, because you may be wondering, like, all right, like, what's the catch? They have to make money. I'm going to get into all of that here. But what you do is you select your LLC, and then your state of formation is Colorado. And then as you go down, you can see that their silver package here is a $50 one-time payment. And then the package fee is at $0, and it's $50 for that state fee. Now, as you look down here, these are some things I want to highlight. They do preparing and filing of the articles of organization, unlimited name searches. So you'll be able to do name searches within the platform to get immediate feedback whether or not that name's available, unlike the state website. And then this is really key, free registered agent service for a year. Now, this is important because if you were to go through a professional registered agent service, you're going to be paying like day one as soon as you start up your LLC. Through Inkfile, it's free, but I do want to highlight the catch on this, because you're kind of wondering, like, all right, they make no money in this package. So I want to highlight some text here, and it says that it's just $119 annually after that. So that registered agent service is free the first year, and then it's $119 year two, year three, year four. So that's how they're able to offer this silver package with the $0 package fee, is because year two, year three, that's when they're going to start charging you. But in my opinion, again, for everything that we discussed in this video, it's so important to have a legit registered agent, and don't throw in some family member or a neighbor down the street to save a few bucks. Now, a couple things I do want to highlight here: when you go to gold and platinum, that's when your package fees start to kick in, so $149 and $299. But there's a couple good things to highlight in the gold package here. One of them is the EIN business tax number. So if you're getting set up as a business and you're trying to make some income, you're most likely going to have to get set up with an EIN. If you're curious, you can do this yourself. This is the website that you want to use when you're setting it up. Like I mentioned earlier, all resources are in the description below, so you can find this free article here, and this will walk you through, if you need an EIN, everything you need to do, and then how to apply. I will tell you from doing this myself that this is a pain in the butt, so that is a nice service that they offer, that they do this for you. The other thing that I wanted to make mention of too is the business banking account. This is really important. So at the beginning of this video, I also talked about commingling funds. So you can probably see where this is going, but basically, if you end up running your personal finances and your business finances through the same bank account, what you're doing is commingling funds. And this is a no-no. This is, again, another indicator that this is not a legit LLC. So again, going back to piercing the corporate veil, that attorney's gonna look for that crack, because you're commingling funds, and see if they can go after not only your business assets, but your personal assets, because you never established a business bank account. So that's why it's so important to kind of just dot your I's and cross your T's when it comes to your LLC. And I like this service because it does a better job of that for you and guiding you throughout the process. So if I did have to pick one, I would go with the gold package, but you can certainly do the silver and then do a lot of these things on your own as well. Now, at the beginning of the video, I also talked about hiring an attorney. Now, of course, the downside to hiring an attorney is it can be expensive, but the upside to it is if you have a more complex business model, let's say you're doing sales in-state and out-of-state, you already have a lot of income coming through, and you have a lot of complexities and potentially liabilities with your business, you're probably gonna wanna go through and hire an attorney. So what I wanna do real quick is show you a tool that I like for that. If you go to Avvo, it's called, this is a lawyer directory, but you can kind of filter it down to LLC lawyers in Colorado. But it can be a little tough to make a decision when you have 75 results. So one of the things I always recommend with this tool is, if you go down, is you can click right here, it says free consultation, and you'll see that we're gonna jump from 75 results right down to 16. And then you can start to look at their reviews and see if they're gonna be a good fit for your business. And this is just a really simple way to find a good attorney who you can consult with, but also not run the meter right away and have a 15-minute consult for free. Now, the downsides of going with an attorney, of course, you you might be spending anywhere from like $800 to $3,000 to set up your LLC. So if you're kind of just a new business getting started, it may not be the best route for you. But if, again, if you have a complex business, it may make more sense. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is saving on taxes. A lot of people think LLC, some sort of tax advantage. There isn't. But with an S-Corp, there is a possible tax advantage. So this video right here at about the 230 mark, I'm going to walk you through the S-Corp tax calculator. And what this is going to do is show you how you can potentially save on taxes if you're already having about $40,000, $50,000 of income in your business. I'm going to walk you through that as well. So I'm going to catch you in that next video, and thank you for using my links in the description below. I truly appreciate it.